On the occasion of India's 72nd Independence Day celebration, the Prime Minister of India announced that India will indigenously send an Indian astronaut into space by 2022. This took many in the international community by surprise, as achieving such a feat in such short span of time is no piece of cake. And so, is the Indian Space Research Organization ready to take on such a challenge? Will it be able to indigenously send an astronaut into space by 2022? Let's find out. It all started back in the year 2003, when China amazed the world by becoming the third nation ever to send a human into space. This sparked curiosity in the mind of the then Prime Minister of India, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who wanted to explore the possibility of indigenously sending an Indian astronaut into space. And thus the manned space mission was first endorsed by the ISRO Policy Planning Committee in the year 2004. The planning committee estimated that a budget of ₹5,000 crore, or US$728 million, was required for initial work on the crewed mission from 2007 till 2012, followed by a crewed mission into space, which would require about ₹12,400 crore, or US$1.8 billion, and a period of 7 years for development. The new government was skeptic about the project, as at that time ISRO was struggling with its GSLV launch vehicle. But eventually, in February 2009, the government of India gave the green light for the human space flight program. A sense of excitement ran across ISRO, as it was about to undertake its most difficult and complex task ever. But their excitement were short-lived, as the government gave a go-ahead only as a pre-project initiative, and not for an official Indian human space program. Not only that, the government even failed to fully fund the pre-project initiative, which it had earlier promised. Not giving up on the project, ISRO continued with whatever funds they had. At the drawing board, ISRO scientists realized how difficult and extremely complex it would be to successfully accomplish the task, all this while astronauts' lives will be at stake. ISRO had to develop from scratch a dedicated and reliable man-rated launch vehicles, crew module, launch escape systems, deorbit and re-entry travel systems, safe and soft landing systems, docking systems, a space suite, environment control and life support systems, astronaut training facilities, and last but not the least, health management and emergency doctor consultation systems. The first test flight of the unmanned crew module was scheduled to take place in 2013. But lack of funds and disinterest from the government made it impossible to do so. In 2014, new government came into power. It was thrilled and extremely excited with the project, and promised to help ISRO in whichever way possible. But, surprisingly, didn't took it seriously until 2017, when it officially accepted the Indian Human Space Flight Program. But again, surprisingly, announced it formally to the public, more than a year later on August 15, 2018. As of today, ISRO has successfully developed launch escape systems, deorbit and re-entry travel systems, safe and soft landing systems, docking systems, a space suit, environment control and life support systems. And it has yet to develop astronaut training facilities, which is scheduled to come up near Bangalore in India, health management and emergency doctor consultation systems, along with other systems. The crew module was earlier designed to be like NASA's Mercury type module, but later upgraded it to be like NASA's Gemini type, to include a third astronaut along with docking capabilities, but ended up actually developing a Soyuz type module. As it's so successful, it is still in service, as the only way to ferry astronauts to and from the International Space Station. And as far as a dedicated and reliable man-rated launch vehicle is concerned, the GSLV Mark III will be enough to do the job. But for more ambitious manned missions, ISRO is currently developing a heavy lift launch vehicle, or the HLV, to double the payload carrying capacity of the GSLV Mark III. we have made a dedicated video on ISRO's heavy lift launch vehicle, which you can watch by clicking on the link appearing on top of the video, and also at the bottom in the description of the video. The HLV will have a dedicated launch site at Char Spaceport, for which the work has already started. Apart from technological development, the project also desperately needed a leadership. And so, Dr. V.R. Lalithambika, with an experience of over 3 decades in the organization, and extensive work experience in both PSLV and GSLV, was officially selected to head India's human spaceflight program. A project to successfully send Indian astronauts into space and bring them back safely. She knows that it's not an easy task, especially when astronauts' lives are at stake, and a minor mistake could turn out to be fatal for the astronauts, turning ISRO's Mission Control Center into a crime scene. At present, considering technological development point of view, ISRO has already developed most of the critical technologies required to send a human into space and bring it back safely, while other remaining systems can easily be developed by 2022. But human spaceflight is not just about developing technologies and systems, but extensively testing them over and over again, to eradicate the possibilities of failures during the actual launch. This will be the main challenge for ISRO. A challenge to develop a foolproof system to send and retrieve astronauts to and from space by 2022. What do you think? Will ISRO be able to send and retrieve astronauts to and from space by 2022? Tell us in the comment section below. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do check out our other videos as well. Links to a few are on your screen. Please subscribe and do not forget to hit the like button. See you in another video. Thanks for watching.